Welcome back to the next episode of The Old Guy in the Net.
Game of 2023. Team here is on a bit of a roll. We want to keep that going. I was off last week on a cruise, missed a couple of games. I don't like missing any games. Like, just when I get in my rhythm, I have to play my way back.
As I play more often, I realize my equipment is now outdated. It's changed, the position has changed, the movements have changed, and therefore, I'm changing. And with that said, I've added this little new feature here that I will put a little light on the equipment that I'm wearing in each, I don't know, episode, maybe each game, because you'll see I go through lots of equipment to finally get to the place where I'm comfortable.
No score. First period. All right, not bad. Not much action either. I'm all right with that right now. Good period, man. What a goal by the young kid, man. Wow. He didn't go out of the corner. He scored falling down. 2-0. 5 minutes left, we're about halfway through. So, one thing I've noticed is, even when I'm not saving the puck, I'm not moving right. I'm not getting myself in good position to make a save.
As I play back this video and listen to my in-game self-analysis, how I'm moving in the net, I can't help but to think back throughout my entire career. This is something that I've always done. I've always critiqued my own game. I didn't need others to tell me how well or how poorly I played. Believe me, I am my own worst enemy in that regard. I'm very aware of my movements, and it's not necessarily whether we won or lost the game. I know how well I played by how I moved and whether I saw the puck or not. You know, there are saves that goalies make when the puck just happens to hit you. You're just in the right place. But then there are other saves where you actually had to physically move, you know, get a good read on the play and then move and get yourself in position to make that save. And when I'm doing all the things correctly and everything is, I feel healthy and mentally there and present, you know, that those are the games in the times where it kind of all comes together and I feel good and I want those games to continue in that frame of mind, just to carry on from one game to the next. And it doesn't happen that way. It, for whatever reason, I guess mainly because we're human, we go through these periods where we don't see the puck. Everything seems to be happening so quickly and our reads are poor and we seem to get bad bounces and, you know, our defensemen are deflecting shots over us or getting in the way and we're not seeing it. And then, you know, you play through it and suddenly it turns around again. And that has happened throughout my career. But again, I think for me, without kind of going through the self-critique of my own play, I don't think I wouldn't be as competitive as I am. It's kind of what keeps me playing my best and trying to achieve a higher level, better performance than the past. I never want to, you know, rest on what I did my last game. It's like I have to prove myself all over again. So it's almost like, I'm a rookie and just starting out. And even at this age, I'm 56 and that's how I feel today. Still trying to get better. I'm still not just you know, putting the equipment on and going out and playing and saying, hey, this is all I can give you. This is what I got. This is who I am. No, I want to get better.
All right, Thursday night. This is the Goons team. This is my first game of the new season. They played last week. They lost 5-3. I was away on a cruise. So here we go, playing the Solar Bears. See what we got.
So as a fairly new player to these leagues, you know, I don't have any history with any of these players. I don't know any of them personally. So there's no bad blood. You know, I'm just here to play the game and try to help my team win. And this particular player here, I believe it's his first game with this team. He doesn't have the matching shirt. No issues this game at all. But I remember in this game, you know, I thought he played a good, strong game. And I remember even commenting on his shirt. I'm like, dude, that's a cool shirt. Old Tampa Bay Buccaneers football team jersey, but it's a hockey jersey. So I remember commenting to him about the shirt and he kind of just shrugged or whatever, but no big deal. In future episodes, you'll see how his play, you know, it starts to change. Let's just put it this way. This might have been the last time we played the Solar Bears and the game was just, there were no issues. It was just clean game. Play the game. On this night, the better team won. And in future games, it seems like every single time we played them, there was an issue. And it just, the issues continued to pile up. And it just felt like, you know, something big eventually was going to happen.
Shot 11-6. Territorial edge goes to them, but the scoreboard goes to us right now.
So for better or worse, as this league changing, it was getting more competitive. The teams were replacing their, let's say, lower rated players with younger, faster players. That was the direction that this league was going. This is what, 35 plus? But the Goons, my team here, they didn't do that. You know, a lot of them were friends and they wanted to stay together. So they didn't mind, you know, not being as competitive, didn't take it as seriously as some of the other teams. They kind of realized they didn't have the skill set to probably win the championship, but, you know, be competitive in every night for the most part. With that said, we goalies got a lot of action and we had, you know, if we played well, then we gave them a chance to win. Otherwise, it was going to be probably a long night. For the most part, you're not going to have an easy night here. That's just the way it was. That's what you signed up for. That's what you agreed to take on. And, you know, that also plays into how this eventually plays out.
Thank you. number one. Good, so we got 5-2, 10 minutes left.
Yeah, we need it, man. We can't get too many chances.
Hey, we're not happy.
That was a good game. That was
pretty.
Why we didn't answer you for falling down?
Let's see, kind of. Keep my head in the game, work on some things without the pressure of being in a game. For instance, today I have the skates that I bought the other Reeboks, the newer ones. They're better than the ones I normally use, but lately when I've played with these, I don't feel comfortable. I'm not moving around in the net the way I want to move. I didn't know if it was the combination of the skates, the change in skates, and the change in pads, the two of them. So I've been varying what I've been wearing. If I'm wearing my new pads, I'm using my older skates. Today, I have the newer skates on with my very old pads. These things, they feel so small now. So I'm kind of trying to figure this out, get comfortable wearing both the new skates and the new pads. Good morning. See you out there. This allows me to work on that. And anyway, cool thing is, right here next to me, first guy on the bench, that's former goalie for the Lightning, Dwayne Roloson is right here playing. Plays as a defenseman, which is pretty cool. He's pretty damn good. Anyway, I got 4 minutes and I'm going to head out there. So, next time you see me, I'll be in the net. Goal today is not to let in any goal. Just like it is whenever I'm playing anywhere else. No rule. Oh, how do you miss that? All right, see you out there. Today, but the puck is fucking going in the net. Just one of those days. just overall bad play today. I don't know. This is what I remember, this feeling on the Sundays. When I first started playing the Sundays, trying to read the play. How can I say this? When the tempo isn't fast, it's really slow. And the shooters have all the time. And some of these guys, they just make unpredictable plays. So you find yourself sliding out of position when you normally, the shot would have came and you would have been in position. But here, today at least, I'm just finding myself almost being, I don't want to say too quick, but just out of position on so many goals. Moving one way and the puck doesn't go that way. And next thing you know, they have an easy open net. I'm not square. I can't get back. I can't get up. Can't reach it. So it's kind of been a little frustrating. I'll close it out. I'll get back out there for the final 20. Hopefully make some saves where I actually move and see the puck and read it correctly. Because right now, even when I tried to bear down, they still scored two goals. And I'm not happy with my overall play. So, and you know, these skates, they feel okay on my feet. But I'll tell you what, I'm not playing well in them. And that's starting to worry me about, am I losing confidence in my skates? Yeah. Lose confidence in your skates and being able to move into position, then you start second-guessing yourself. So I think for now I'm going to have to not wear these particular skates in the game and just save them for these pickups and try to get myself used to them. Save my older skates for my games where I'm very confident in them. I feel fine with them.
And you won't have to review that. Wow. The crowd loves it, as they should. What a save.
What a save by Dwayne Roloson. And Cleary just cradled it and took enough time with this that Roloson, with his wonderful second effort.
As I mentioned at the beginning of this episode, Dwayne Roloson, the professional goaltender, he skates regularly as a defenseman, and he was gracious enough to take a little time between shifts and talk to me about goaltending. I had a lot of questions in regards to basically learning how to butterfly, you know, being a goalie from the 80s and 90s when that style wasn't used. I was curious because I know he played at that same time.
When you learned how to, that's when you started.
Switching. Yeah, I had to change from stand up skate save guy.
Yeah.
To, I became a hybrid type of guy.
Yeah.
More down first, butterfly slide. Like I sort of combined movements
right
with the butterfly slide. So I stayed almost like a skate save guy
okay
with my movements.
Yeah.
And then I relied on my slides and everything else afterwards.
So you were still making skate saves?
No.
You didn't? All right, so you turned the pad completely over.
Yeah.
First year as a pro.
Yeah.
While at UMass, you were total skate save, stand-up type guy, hybrid,
yeah,
if you will, right?
Did stand you know real? Skate save, 100%.
Total, not even like at the time, Ruahi kind
no
of? No, not
no
even. All right, 100%. Wow. So what were the tricks? What did you learn or how? What type of exercises did you use to work on?
Repetition, like goalie practice is going 3 hours.
And
just strictly working on that.
Just going side-side.
Yeah.
And is it, when you push, are you pushing off the toe, the entire blade, the back, the heel?
You never push off anything besides the ball of your foot.
The ball of your foot.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
So just like the only thing is,
yeah,
you do everything the same, butterfly, yeah, or the seat push,
yeah,
shuffles,
yeah,
everything else,
yeah,
but you're just going into a butterfly, a like you're doing. Instead of shuffling and staying on our feet, shuffle into a butterfly. T-push into a T-push, instead of doing a full stop, when you T-push, you're ready to go, now you're pushing into a butterfly stop. You're not actually T-pushing and then going into it, you're T-pushing setting up like you're going to T-push, and then you're going to butterfly.
So how are you controlling, when you're sliding, how are you stopping? You don't want to go too far, right?
So pushing your stick. And your idea is trying to get back to the post.
East to west.
You're going
side to side.
You're going back to the post, not laterally.
Okay.
Everything's an inverted V, how we move.
So I know I'm here. I make a save. It drops to my right.
Behind you.
My old process would have been T-glide quick over there, stay up. And now I feel like it isn't. It's drop down and push with the left leg.
Takes you too long to get off.
If I make the save, it was there.
Yeah.
My stick goes.
Yeah.
My head.
That was the last time I gave him a side kick with that back bomb. He fucking broke my helmet.
So it's
he then came back.
Head, everything's going to go together, right?
Yeah. And then you're bought,
then
you've
been sent to push up both.
Everything's going to go with you. See, it's, that's not what's.
You're
it's
up, Rolly.
Brain, because it isn't the
when
way
it,
we
whenever it comes.
Okay. Up.
Grew up playing, right? It's, it's so different.
Nothing's changed with how we grew up, or at least the way I was taught.
Yeah.
Except for the only thing that's changed is instead of staying on our feet, we're pushing into a slide. Butterfly. We're pushing into a butterfly.
Pushing into a butterfly.
Yeah.
It's a muscle.
Guys are telling me the newer blades will help. The newer goalie skates.
Like
I
don't
know. Is that true? Do you believe that?
I shaved off all those white collars. I shaved it all off before all the new stuff.
You did,
yeah.
To give you a little more blade on the ice.
Yeah.
So you felt it was catching the ice.
I would hit.
Yeah.
And then I would, I'd sharpen my skates. My inside edge would be one line up. So instead of being flat, this side would be higher.
And did you?
So I get better bite.
Did you sharpen them like every week or every how often?
Yeah, mine were at 5/8.
Yeah.
So I sharpen them all the time.
Every time going out.
Yeah, because as soon as you hit the post, you steam them up.
So dude, right now, I'll sharpen my skates probably once a year.
Yeah, what do you get them sharpened at though?
In Brandon, that's
Hollow.
Is it 3/8?
So you're flat.
Yeah.
Yeah. No.
But you're thinking...
No, you're 3/8 is sharp.
Right, but it'll last the whole year.
Yeah, go to 5/8.
5/8 and sharpen them often?
No, you don't even have to sharpen them often.
No.
Just go to 5/8. Now you're not wasting all that energy in the ice.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
When you're sharp, you cut into the
ice. Don't turn your back
all
on.
That is energy wasted.
You don't want to be sharp.
We want to be able to slide on top of the ice.
Okay.
Shoot, you're going from 3/8 to 5/8, it's going to feel, you're going to feel like Bambi out there.
And what about the cowling? Do I need to shave it or no?
Just
go to 5/8 chain first.
Yeah, if you get a sander at home, you got a grinder. Just grind the inside out, just off a little bit.
Awesome. That's a really good tip.
In the next episode, I travel 1,850 miles to Moncton, New Brunswick for the ATC hockey tournament. Come back and check it out.